We start with discussing this bevel gears. So we have a bevel gear here. So your input is B here, which is connected to D. And it is already given that D and E are compound gears, so which is having same speed. And D is connected to C, which is rotating freely. It is not an output shaft, actually. It is not connected to the output shaft. It is rotating freely on the output shaft, whereas E is also connected to F, that is connected to the output shaft. So based on that rotation, so the question is, what happens if the C is fixed and when the C is rotating, right? What happens to the output shaft speed, right? That is the question, right? So we started with this. So first we identified what are the speeds available. So the speed is, you have a speed in gear B, speed D and E are of same speed, and F is having one separate speed, and C is having separate speed. So, and then along with that, you also have arm, right? These are the overall speeds, right? Now, when you consider here, we start with gear B. We will identify one by one what is the relation with respect to gear B for all the other gears, right? Once we complete that, we will make a tabulation and we will complete the process, right? Okay, gear B. So you know that B is connected to D. B is connected to D. So which means I can write, so my speed ratio, so ND by NB is equal to TB by TD, right? So for my understanding, I am putting a negative here. So even though it is connected in my external, right? For my understanding, I'm putting a negative because next time varumbodhu positive maro. So the kaga vandha I am considering here. So in that case, I will consider ND. ND is equal to minus TB by TD into NB. Right? You know what is your TB. TB is given, which is 20. So minus 20 by TD. TD is 60. NB. So what is your ND now? Minus 1 by 3 NB. Right? Any doubt on this?
No, sir.
Yeah, the first step is over. Next, D and E are of same speed. So I can directly write what is your NE. NE is also equal to minus 1 by 3 NB. Right? So because compound gears. Right? Now, we will see one by one. We will see from D. D is connected to C. So D is connected to C. So there is a relation between D and C. Right? It is also external connection. Right? So in that case, I can write it as NC by ND is equal to minus TD by TC. Right? Or I can write it as ND, sorry, NC is equal to minus TD by TC into ND. Right? We know already what is your ND. Let me substitute it. So your NC is equal to minus. I know what is TD. TD is 60 and TC is 80. So 60 by 80. And this ND, you know that this ND is, I can substitute this. Okay. In that case, I will get minus 1 by 3 NB. Right? So what is your relation? What is your NC now?
NC is equal to NB by 4.
So NB by 4. Okay. Right? So this is also over. Right? So next, we see the relation of other two. So E and F. There is a relation between E and F. We will write for that. So EF. Right? It is also an external connection. So NF by NE is equal to minus TE by TF. So again, NF is equal to minus TE by TF into NE. Right? So we know again NE is also 1 by 3 of NB. We can substitute that. So NF is equal to minus TE. TE is, we can able to see 30 and TF is 32. So 30 by 32 into minus 1 by 3 NP. What you are getting? What is your NF?
1 by 16 NB.
So you are getting 1 by 16 NB. Right? This is the next relation. Anything else other than this? That's it. We completed. So all the speeds are identified in terms of B. Right? So only thing is I have to make a tabulation and I am going to identify. Right? Okay. Let me proceed with the tabulation. Arm. This is gear B. Next, compound gear D and E. Next, gear. What is the next gear? Gear C and gear F. So gear C and gear F. Right? The first thing is, you know that we are going to fixing the arm. Arm is fixed. And plus one rotation for gear B. So what you'll get? You'll get zero. This will be plus one. Compound gear DE. So multiply with, so substitute as NB as one. So you'll get minus 1/3. So put it as 1/3. Don't put negative. This is not, this is in some other axis. Right? It is in 3D. So as I told you, so when you look in the right hand side, you will get, and you can be able to see that it is rotating in clockwise. When you look in left hand side, you can able to see that it is rotating in anti-clockwise. Since it's a bevel gear, we no need to mention that sign. Okay? Just write the value alone. Okay, so mostly in book they will put star. They will put star here, right, indicating that sign you can't able to identify the sign. Okay, so next gear C. Gear C, it is NB by 4, so it is 1 by 4. And gear F is 1 by 16.
Sir, can I just repeat, sir? Why we are not mentioning the sign in this for bevel gear one more time? Can I repeat, sir?
The thing is, so bevel gear is having in this direction. It is in other direction. It is not like our regular gear, right? What happens is, since it is in a perpendicular direction, if you view in this angle, you can able to see that your gear is rotating in clockwise. Similarly, if you view in top view, you can able to see that it is rotating in anti-clockwise. So there is a confusion in identifying the rotation, right? Because this is in some other view. It is in some other view or some other dimension. So that's why we are leaving that. So we are not considering that. But in calculation, we are putting negative because of external bigger. Because this is, this gear is related to the other gear. Suppose this negative will become positive here. Which means if this is rotated in clockwise, this will also rotate in clockwise. Okay. For that only we put negative here. But when writing the table, you don't need to put that. Okay. Can you able to understand?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Next, we will consider the gear. So X rotation in gear B. X rotation in gear B. So which means multiply with X, we'll get X sorry, 0, x, 1 by 3 x, we'll put star. So this is 1 by 4 x and 1 by 16 x. So add y. So y, right? So next thing is I have to take what is the total. So this is y, this is x plus y, this is x by 3 plus y, right? This is x by 4 plus y, and this is x by 16 plus y. Right, so these are the overall thing. So now we'll go for the question. So the question says that you have to identify what is the output shaft. Right, output shaft is connected to F. Right, output shaft is connected to F. Okay, so which means this is your output. Output is F. Enough, I have to identify what is the speed of gear F. So I want to identify gear F speed. Right, what is the speed? So that is important. Okay, what are the given conditions here? Given data, right?
Sir, first, input there is a speed on the 1000 RPM.
Yeah, rotation?
Anti-clockwise.
Yeah, so that is the common data which is given. So input speed, they are given input speed, right? Input speed is 1000 RPM plus 1000 because it is anti-clockwise. What is input gear here? What is input gear according to the diagram?
B
is the input gear. So which means B is x plus y, right? So x plus y is equal to 1000. This is a common data. Now, based on this common data, they are given two conditions. First condition, gear A is fixed. What happens? Next condition, gear A rotate 10 RPM anti-clockwise. What is the condition? First condition, gear A is fixed. Is it gear A? Sorry, gear C. Gear C is fixed. Gear C is fixed. Right? So which is gear C here? Gear C is here. So x by 4 plus y is equal to 0. It should be 0. So x by 4 plus y would be equal to 0. Right? Okay. In that case, what is the value? So you got two relations now. Right, this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. Solve 1 and 2. Right, solve 1 and 2.
Sir,
find what is the value of
1333.33 RPM.
33.33 RPM. Okay. What about y?
-333.33.
Yeah. So everyone getting the same answer? Okay. Now you have to identify gear F. What is gear F? X by 16 plus F or plus Y. That is gear F. Speed gear F. If x by 16 plus y, which is equal to x, you know, 1333.33 divided by 16, y is minus 333.33. What is the speed? Okay, minus 250 RPM. Right? This is the first answer. Right? So, okay. So the next one. Right, next one is second substitution. What they say, gear C is rotating 10 RPM anti-clockwise direction, right? So now they are not saying gear C is fixed. Gear C makes 10 RPM, plus 10 RPM, right? What is the formula for gear C? Gear C is X by 4 plus Y. Now, X by 4 plus Y is equal to 10. Let me consider this as equation 3. Now, again, solve 1 and 3. Right? You know what is the equation 1. So, equation 1 is X plus Y is equal to 1000. Right? Equation 3, now there is a new equation now, which is X by 4 plus Y is equal to 10. What is the value of X and what is the value of Y? 1000.
0 or minus 3.
Sorry?
Correct, answer.
Okay. So now we got this. So now let us identify what is the speed of gear F. Gear F is X by 16 plus Y. So 1320 by 16 minus 320 minus 237.3.
Five.
Okay, 5 RPM. Right. So these are the two conditions we arrived. Right. What is the speed in terms of this? Right. Okay. Now I will add one more question. You say that. Just look here. Your gear C is fixed now. When your gear C is fixed, your RPM, output RPM, is minus 250 RPM. Right? If gear C is rotating at 10 RPM, your speed is a little bit reduced. It is going to minus 237.5 RPM. Right? Can you tell me, right, what is the minimum speed required, minimum speed required in gear C so that your gear F rotates in anti-clockwise direction? So still now your gear F is rotating in clockwise and a negative over the answer. Right? If a minimum எவ்வளவு speed இருந்ததுன்னா gear C ல minimum speed இவ்வளவு இவ்வளவு இருந்ததுன்னா gear F வந்து clockwise-க்கு மாறும். எப்படி ஐடென்டிஃபை பண்றது? How to do that? What is the first condition? X plus Y is equal to 1000. Second, I should have plus 1. This one should be plus 1, right? This one should be plus 1, which means I can write as X by 16 plus Y will be plus 1. Plus 1. Why I am giving plus 1? Because it has to rotate in anti-clockwise, at least for 1 RPM. Right? So you can relate this to, right? So this is, I think this is equation 1 and this is equation 4. If you relate this, you will get what is the value of X and what is the value of Y. So 1065 and minus?
Minus 65.6. 1065.6, sir.
Okay. 0.6, okay, minus 65.6, right? So in that case, gear C, what is gear C? Gear C is X by 4 plus Y. Let us identify what is X by 4 plus Y. So X by 4 plus Y, which is nothing but 1065.6 divided by 4 minus 65.6. What is the answer for this? So 200.8. So it means that if gear C rotates at 200 RPM, automatically what happens? Your output gear is also shifting its rotation. It is changing its direction of rotation. So clockwise la adukku munadi vandha clockwise la rotate aayirukum. Didin vandu anti clockwise la rotate aagum. Right? So this is also a possibility.